Good morning, children. How are you all? Fine? Good. My name is Gayatri, English teacher of Dr. Besant School. Today we are going to have a 4th standard English subject. Are you all ready with the books which I told you yesterday, children? Very good. So before starting a companion, let's see our studio books. Please open your studio books, children. So this is your studio book, right? Open this book, children. Open this book. Page 44. Now, whatever the grammar topic we learned in this second lesson, children, possessive nouns. Means which it belongs to a particular person or thing or anything, whatever they may be. When have you described that? By giving an apostrophe and S, it shows that it belongs to that particular person. It is not the plural form. If it is in plural, the noun is, we have to give the same apostrophe after S. That those all we have read in the, we have read in this lesson, right? So regarding that possessive nouns only, we have to prepare a concept map. That concept with examples, what is the meaning of that particular noun? You have to tell some examples also. That map today we are going to do. So here there is a heading, no? Possessive pronouns. Okay. Possessive nouns. Here, how do we use them? What is the question here? Why do we use them? Why do we use them? Here they gave you an example. With singular nouns. With singular nouns. Use an apostrophe. When it is singular, where you'll put that apostrophe? Between the noun and the S. Yes or no? Before S we have to give. And an S. First apostrophe, then S. For example, sister is one, then apostrophe S. Usha, singular only, no? Yes. Like this. Now, with irregular plurals, this also I told you. Plural noun.
And here with some other also they taught, no? With
dash nouns.
Okay.
So children, tell me, why do we use possessive nouns?
To show the relationship or belongingness of the noun to the object. In the object place, whatever noun is there, what is the relationship between them? With the belongingness of those two nouns, we use this possessive noun. Yes or no, children? So write the same. To show a relationship of belonging between one thing and
another. to show a relationship between
one noun to the another noun. What is the belongingness of those two nouns? We use this possessive noun.
Yes, understood, children. What is
that? Read along with me once. To show a relationship of belonging between one thing and another.
Read again. To show a relationship of belonging between
one thing and
another. Now, plurals
also we taught for with regular plurals and irregular plurals.
Irregular plural, I think already they gave that side. So, for regular plural, we have to write here. Okay. So, before that, we already learned with the singular nouns. Yes or no? Singular noun is simply you have to put an apostrophe and then s. It shows us that it is a possessive noun.
How can we know that the noun is whether a possessive noun or a general noun? By saying this apostrophe s or s apostrophe? By saying this
only we can come to a conclusion that whether it is a
general noun or a possessive noun. Yes or no, children?
Yes. So for singular, there is no change. Simply we'll put an apostrophe then s.
That's all. The work is done. Now next, coming to plural nouns. So in plurals also we have two different type of plurals. Regular plurals is where we add only s to that
noun.
Then the plural is done. With that regular plural, have we, right? And with irregular plurals means man, men, child, children. In such cases, what women, women. In such cases, what should we do? That you have to write here. So with
first
regular plural,
fill here regular plural. Use use an apostrophe. Yes or no?
First you have to put the s, because it's a regular plural, you'll write the plural, then you get the apostrophe.
Here for example, what can be the
example? You can write brother, brothers, sisters, sisters, the same.
Sisters also you can write, or not brothers. Brothers apostrophe.
Yes. Now, with irregular plurals like man, men,
what should you do? Use an apostrophe and s. Yes. So for example, children's, s apostrophe s. Yes, children, first you copy it down. Once again I'll explain you, then you can clearly understand what is all about. Okay, children, that C is small. If the place, whatever they are given there, is not sufficient, write small letters, children. Okay, children. Okay, children. Touch the line and write
the finger gap
properly. If the time which I am giving you is not sufficient, pause the video and write. If not, you can copy from the PDF which I have already sent you. Yes? You can understand now, children, what are possessive nouns? They shows us the relationship and belongingness of the two
nouns.
So, how can you tell that whether it is a possessive noun or a general noun?
How can you identify that it is a possessive noun?
we are saying this s apostrophe or apostrophe s. So when we write this apostrophe s, when the noun is singular,
then we write apostrophe s.
For
example, sisters, sisters. So the noun is plural, regular noun.
We write s
apostrophe, like brothers, yes, apostrophe. If the
noun is
irregular plural, then we will write again.
Generally, how
we write for singular? We write like that only, apostrophe, yes.
So I think you
all are very clear with this concept map. No, children, see, concept map is nothing but by seeing this map, we can easily identify that. We can easily know the details of positive nouns. Okay, regarding that positive
nouns,
everything we should show it on a map. That is concept map. Okay, children.
So every details of this
positive nouns we gave here, meaning with singular nouns have we read, with plural nouns have we read, again with plural nouns, two type of plural nouns. With regular have we read, with irregular have we read.
Everything we explained in this one chart
only. That is concept map. Right, children? Now, in the last activity which is left here is you 2E in your companion book, children.
In 2E, it is a teamwork if you observe. Imagine that you are taking part in a potluck.
We used to have the housewife meal in our school, like that only. School lunch, have we had our school lunch? Like that, if
you have a potluck meal with your classmates, what do? Generally, we call it
some guests for that potluck meal. There, everyone will bring one item. We all sit together and eat. One will be the head and we will
decide
who will prepare what and in which quantity, how many are coming, everything one by one will work and make that pot meal
or this full
lunch a grand success.
So regarding this and even backside also you have the same continuation. You have an event in the school. Have you felt working in that event? And have you planned in a team? How many members participated in that team?
And
what are the roles they played while working in team? Everything you need to discuss. So these two children will do once you come back to school. This we can't do right now because you won't write your own ideas. It won't look nice even for me also to read. So it's better once you come back to school, we'll do this 2E part. Just right now, ignore that. So I think leaving the 2E, rest all in lesson 2. Studio book, companion book, we have already completed. Right, children? I think that you all are very clear with the topics which we have covered so far. If you have any doubt in any of the topic, please select the
video and listen again
and again. Still, if you have any doubts, from now again, our Zoom meetings will be doing with me only, no? You can clear all your doubts in that Zoom meeting. Right, children? And I wish everyone to attend that Zoom meeting so that your doubts all will be clear. Mm-hmm. Right?
So, children,
that's all for today. And before closing, once again, I want to give you a brief description about this possessive noun and we close because it's a
very important topic.
So children, tell me, what is a possessive noun? It is a noun which shows the relationship or belongingness between two nouns, between one thing to the another thing. Okay, that relationship is shown by the possessive noun. So how can we know that it is a possessive noun? How can we know the relationship? By giving this apostrophe. Then if you give us, if there is no apostrophe here, we generally say sisters means it is a plural. When we give this apostrophe, it says it belongs to that sister. Yes or no? So apostrophe, yes, in the sense it is a possessive noun. It belongs to that particular candidate. So in that singular plurals, we have singular and plural. Singular is only one, no? For that we simply put apostrophe, yes. And plurals, again, we have two type of plurals. Regular plurals, which we generally add s to the noun and we get the plural. In such cases, after s we give the apostrophe. By seeing that only we can know that it is a plural noun. Here also we can get the plural, but it is an irregular. We don't add s. We change the word only, complete spelling. For that we can add apostrophe s simply. Right, children? As for singular nouns have we write, the same we write with irregular nouns also, plural nouns also. Okay, children, and with regular plurals only, a small change occurs is after s, you will give the apostrophe. Right, children, I think you all are very clear with this. If you see this concept map, if you have any doubts also, those will be clear. Still, if you have any doubts, in the next Zoom meeting, I'll clear all your doubts. Right, children? I'll meet you in the next class. Be ready with your studio books only. Fine. Pencil, eraser, sharpener and water bottle. Then take care. Stay home and safe.
Bye.
Bye.